Thank you, President Putin. I'd like to go back to Iran for a second. One of the things that the United States would like to see Iran do is to obviously withdraw from Syria. The U.S. National Security Advisor just last week said that the United States is going to now stay in Syria as long as Iran and its proxies are there. Russia's been very clear. Russia says that the U.S. military's presence in Iran is illegal. What can you do about the U.S. being in Syria?
There are two possibilities in order to stabilize the situation, to improve it. First of all, the U.S. should get a mandate of the UN Security Council for the presence of their armed forces at the territory of a third country, in this case, at the territory of Syria. Or they should get an invitation of the legal government of the Syrian Arab Republic in order to bring their military personnel to the country. There is no other third way of ensuring the presence in the international law.
To change the U.S.'s position. The U.S. says it's going to stay, that Iran has to leave, and the U.S. will stay until Russia, until Iran pulls out of Syria. So what can Russia do?
The U.S. in this case, as we understand, can just easily resort to reading the U.N. Charter. Then they will see that I am speaking the right things. There is nothing new about that. The U.S. in this case are violating the U.N. Charter and the international law. Their military presence at the territory of another country, of the country they are present at, without the resolution, without any permissions, without invitations, it's illegal. There is nothing good about that. Proceeding from the fact that we still do cooperate in Syria with our U.S. partners in combating terrorism, in combating the terrorists of the Islamic State, but while the Islamic State organization is being eliminated at the territory of Syria, we are still not getting any international explanation, legitimization of why the U.S. is longer present there. Or we should strive for the situation when there would be no, absolutely no foreign forces at the territory of Syria. Yes, including Russia. If the decision will be taken at the governmental level of the Syrian Arab Republic.
You think that that's going to hold?
What does it have to do with oil, I wonder? Well, perhaps it has something to do with oil, if we consider that Syria is also an oil producer, and still there is some influence on the markets. In this case, that's true. We need a stable Syria, without a doubt, and not to mention other aspects, speaking about the international security and combating terrorism. That is a very good deal, I'd like to say, between Russia and Turkey in this case, because it meant let us avoid yet another bloodshed. You see, the essence of the deal is that we agreed to create a demilitarized zone 15-20 kilometers deep within the de-escalation area in the vicinity of Idlib, that is the Idlib area. And I'd like to point out that right now we truly proactively work on implementing these agreements. And our Turkish partners too. We see that. We are thankful for that to them. We appreciate that and are going to work with them further with the support of Iran in this case.
To energy, President Putin, and talk about Nord Stream 2. That's the pipeline that Gazprom wants to build between Russia and Germany. The President of the United States has said his opinion about this. He says that Germany is effectively a hostage already of Russia because it depends on Russia for so much of its energy and gas.